Hi, I'm Felice.
And I'm Justin.
From A Little Bit of Personality. And 2014 is coming to a close, and it's been a big year for aLBoP.
Yes, yes it has. And I lost a tooth.
Part of a tooth.
Yeah, didn't really lose a tooth. But yeah, we'll get it fixed at some point. But yeah, we're super proud of all the content we've made for you guys this year. But it's also been the year of the growing pains for aLBoP, which has also been good. It's been needed. Now we got those done.
Yeah, before the cognition process and stick figures, late last October, we were geeking out when we'd get 5,000 hits in a month.
Yeah.
Then when November dawned and we had content you couldn't find anywhere else, explaining the way the mind really works, we were suddenly getting over 3 times that in a month.
Yeah.
And now, a year later, we get that many hits in a few days. The number of visitors to aLBoP in the last 6 months is now 12 and a half times the amount that we got in our first 6 months.
Yeah, yeah. And, you know, that's great, but what's even cooler in a way is that you guys have been so great. You've asked such great questions, such awesome ideas and thoughts you have that we want to talk about. Just such great questions about how personality typing works and how to apply it for real in your lives. How you're asking advice for how to be you, how to be more you, how to be awesome and heroic as the people you are, and how to better understand everyone around you. And it's just so awesome.
Yeah, all this is so amazing, and we can honestly say we've never been happier or more fulfilled than we have in the last year and 3/4. But it's still a lot for just the two of us to handle, and sometimes we get overwhelmed.
Well.
Okay, I get overwhelmed. Especially when it comes to making decisions that could seriously affect other people's lives and realizing that responsibility is in my hands. What if I say the wrong thing and they make the wrong decision? What if I take too long to say anything at all and they think I don't care about them? What if because they think that I don't care about them, they think they're like nobody cares about them and they want to kill themselves? I've taken way too long now. No email could possibly mean enough now. I'm an EP. Consequences scare me. Hey, I want that on a t-shirt.
Seriously. But yeah, so long story short, we had a ton more content than we had planned this year than we were actually able to get out to you. We underestimated how much we have to work on so many other things. We want to do all the rest of the Type Heroes, which we're so excited to do. And character spotlights. We get back to doing specific articles about specific characters. That'll be very fun again. And answering all your awesome questions.
So many questions.
Yeah. And the thank you videos, which are our next big thing we want to be hitting. Catch you on those. And, of course, the infamous Avengers post that Khaleesi's kept promising you.
Oops. It'll still be really awesome, I swear. But the one thing I promised this year that I couldn't let slide was facial typing, which I promised in our very first video would be later this year. Well, it's about as late in the year as we could possibly get, and we're just not ready to release the facial typing series.
And really, it's because it's so big. There's so much information. I mean, faces are complex things. I know there have been some approximation of facial typing, not necessarily in terms of psychology, but various people are trying to see patterns in faces and what they say about people. It's kind of an old and goofy thing, and often very, very oversimplified. Faces are more complex than just these simple little things, and people are more complex than that. And so even though some of these other systems do hit on some real trends, real facial typing is such a big, complex thing.
Yeah, and so while we've been observing and coming to understand the principles of facial typing pretty much since the inception of aLBoP, it's one thing to get to the point where we can do it ourselves and completely and consistently, and a completely different thing to lay those principles out and explain them in a way that you can understand and use them over and over again. And on top of that, we've learned that faces are a little hard to describe in writing.
Brat's eyes? Meandering noses? Face concentrate? When did people become juice? Who wrote this?
But we're working on it.
Yeah, yes we are. In the meantime, this video is here to give you a little sneak peek at just what facial typing is, and what it isn't, of course, why and how it works, and just how awesome and powerful and cool it can be. And also, it's led to some really cool realizations about cognition.
That we don't want to go into too much yet.
Okay.
There's some things that need a lot more background, and I don't want to get angry Google notifications.
Cool game changers, yes.
All in good time, my young apprentice. All in good time.
Okay, so then what is facial typing?
Facial typing, as A Little Bit of Personality has discovered it, is the understanding of how a person's face naturally matches up with the way they think. That each of the 16 personality types, as defined by the variables found here, has its own unique facial composition that, unbeknownst to it, represents perfectly its type specialization and what means the most to it in the world.
That's right, your face!
So, you know, we started out with the cognition, you know, seeing how people think and why they think that way, the cognition steps, all that kind of stuff, separating it from the more surfacey behaviors. And then we start noticing patterns from there, seeing that people who think similarly have similar facial structures, similar facial features, and we kept being surprised at different patterns we'd see. Just kind of letting these observations kind of take shape of their own accord. And then the more it came together, the more it started making so much more sense than we would have originally thought.
Yeah, because while all faces have similarities, just like all people and types have similarities, people of the same personality type have the same facial scaffolding,
yeah,
I like to call it.
Yeah.
The underlying structure that is the architecture of what they look like, underneath the things like coloring and hereditary influences.
Yeah, so when we started noticing this, like, hey, there's something actually going on here. We wanted to find out more about it. We started noticing, well, we kind of figured it had to be, and we noticed that indeed it was universal, independent of race or age, that facial typing across personality types doesn't matter what your ethnicity is, and doesn't matter if you're a little baby or an old person or whatever, that the facial typing is consistent across all those boundaries.
And even?
Oh, yeah. And even multiples, like twins and triplets. For example, when I was in college, I knew these three girls who were identical triplets. And most people who didn't know them very well was like, well, which one's that one? They couldn't tell the difference. They were identical. But us who were friends with them, we got to know, well, that one's that one. I was about to say their names, but no, that one's that. Anyway, so we could tell really quickly which one was which. And weren't really sure how. Didn't really think about how. It's amazing how much the brain can understand faces. But then after we gained facial typing, I was like, okay, but you can't really tell me that all twins and triplets are the same personality type, because like these triplets are so different from each other. So I got out of picture, like, okay, and then as soon as I looked at it, I was like, whoa! And while they were identical, they looked so different. Like, it could not be unseen once I saw it. They're like, this one here has total ESTP eyes, this one here is total ENFJ jaw, and I'm like, oh, that she really was very ENFJ-like, and that one was so ESTP, and just seeing how they're identical, and yet they didn't all have those same eyes. They didn't all have that same... The noses were different. The cheeks were different, even though they're identical twins. Like, once they see it, like, whoa, now I see how I was able to tell the difference between them without even realizing it. They're identical, and yet their scaffolding was different. You had one identical triplet who had the ESTP scaffolding, another identical triplet had the ENFJ scaffolding, and it was totally different.
Yeah, we get that feeling a lot, that can't be unseen feeling.
Yeah, well, and with Harry Potter, the Weasley twins, we looked at actors of Weasley twins, and once you saw it, it's like, oh my gosh, now
yeah.
We know what types they are, and that cannot be unseen, how their faces are actually different from each other, even though they're identical twins.
Yeah, and it was awesome, honestly, to get a great email from an INFJ and to show Justin a picture and say, oh my gosh, that's what you would look like if you were black.
Yeah, it really was.
Am I supposed to say African-American? I don't think he was American.
And so it's really cool because while race and genetics do mean that people from different ethnic backgrounds are going to have trends and features, you know, skin color, face shape, whatever, nose width, eye shape, all of that. What's really awesome on facial typing is that, like we said, you can still see a person's personality type past all that, regardless of age or race, which means we're all so much more alike, so much more similar and linked than we might think when we only look at the more obvious racial differences. And so it's very cool how it brings everyone together, makes us all more similar that way.
Oh, it's like a Lifetime movie.
Now, in practice, though, we have a little nephew who's really young, who's refusing to be potty trained. And so he can't really talk much yet. It's hard to type him by, like, say, talking to him because he doesn't really talk. But facial typing him, it's like, oh, well, here's the type he is, should I say? It's like, oh, that's an ENFP, that's a little ENFP face. And when we told that to his parents, they were like...
Which did line up with everything he did.
Yeah. So, like, in retrospect, he was a very, you know, not yet speaking ENFP, the way he reacted and the stuff he prioritizes, that we care most about. And so all of a sudden everything makes sense, because the way they've been trying to potty train him was like, in retrospect, you're like, oh, that is the wrong way to talk to an ENFP. They will not react well to that. And so they totally changed around their whole strategy of potty training him, and overnight, I think it was pretty much literally over a night, he was potty trained. And it was like, all of a sudden, you know, they've been having those troubles with him, but then when they recognize through facial typing, oh, here's how he cognates, here's what he prioritizes, here's what's important to him, here's what matters to him, they would have changed their tactics, and bam, it just worked, when they've been having so much trouble with him before. And so if it works for a little kid who can't even talk, how much more can it work for adults, and help us be able to know how to interact with people around us just by seeing them? And it doesn't oversimplify people any more than cognition does. This helps us understand their vast dynamic cognition right away.
Another thing that's awesome is facial focal points. Yeah. It's one of my favorite things. That each facial type, like a painting, has a place that naturally draws your eye. A unique emphasis that says something about that type. That's
it really
the coolest
does.
Thing.
It's really funny.
Honestly, it's funny how fitting they are.
Yeah, they really are. You know, it kind of reflects their cognition in very funny ways. Another one of our favorite things about this is that it brings out, it emphasizes and celebrates all these very different types of beauty, of good looks. That the way you look as your personality type is awesome because of the ways in which it reflects the things that are important to you and the kind of person who you are at your core. And so often we're kind of implicitly told by culture that we have to look like someone else in order to look pretty or handsome or whatever, in order to look good. And you even see it among celebrities. You say, oh, well, they're trying to look like this person now. Or it's funny, the trends in different eras say, well, everyone's trying to look like that personality type. I didn't even realize, and that's what we're trying to look like. And does it make sense that culture would have liked that personality type at that time? And so it's very funny seeing that. But facial typing shows you that you don't have to try to look like somebody else, that your outsides reflect naturally who you are on the inside, and that is so much more charismatic and attractive than trying to be something else.
Yeah, I know that growing up as a teenager, that I wanted to look like anybody else so often, that on the one hand, I loved me and I loved the way that I was. On the other hand, you know, I hated things like my nose, and I hated the shape of my face.
I always thought her nose was adorable because it says so much about Calice. It really does. but she's always been embarrassed about it because in her mind, she thought you had to look like somebody else.
Little did I know that it's an ENTP nose. Little did I know that it says so much about me.
It really does. And your cheeks and your eyes and the shape of your face. There's a little square face and all of it.
Cutie. Little square face.
Heart-shaped. Heart-shaped is what you like it.
Well, yeah. Anyway. There's so much that we want to talk about with this. And so we're going to be releasing, I think, probably a lot of these videos in the preceding months.
Putting it out in little bite-sized chunks because there's so much information.
Yeah, because we want to get everybody ready for the full unveiling of facial typing.
Yes, you can use it.
Because there's just so much information that if we gave you guys all of it now, you'd be way too overwhelmed. And we'd be way overwhelmed at trying to say it right all at one time.
All these charts about here's how the jaw works, here's where the focal points are, and we're so excited to do those charts. And then we're excited to show you a whole bunch of these faces. Like, here is a parade of ISTJ faces. You can see how, oh my gosh, they
and
are all the same.
And it's amazing how much it can't be unseen.
Yes,
it's,
once you see it, it's
the
like,
coolest thing.
Yeah, exactly.
It's amazing how much then you'll talk to people and be in a conversation with someone you've never talked to before. And be able to see, oh my gosh, this is where you're coming from.
Yeah, yeah. Helps you be able to interact with people a lot more smoothly.
You know, or how Justin will watch a documentary and...
watch a military documentary. Or watch a documentary about the military, I'm like, there's an INTJ, there's an INTJ, there's an INTJ. And so it's very funny that way. But yeah.
Yeah, with so many things. You know, or you watching actors and actresses or musicians, and it's like, oh, there's
ESFJ.
Or fashion bloggers on YouTube. Oh my gosh, there's another ESFJ. ESFJ.
Which is great. That's what
they
prioritize, what they love.
That's the
thing.
You do what
things.
You love, and we're all about helping you appreciate who you are for who you are.
So you can use it more and be and feel. Don't have to have that confidence of feeling like you're going to be someone else. You can go forward as you and feel like you.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
And so, that's what we're still going to be about in 2015. We thank you guys for coming with this on this journey with us through 2014.
And while I don't want to tempt fate by saying no more growing pains, we really have gotten done with a lot of necessary growing pains that are now done.
Yeah.
So, yeah. Very, very, very excited for the next year. Happy New Year.
And please come along this journey with us so we can help you be the person you want to be.
Yeah.
We love you so much. Happy New Year's.
Happy New Year. Okay, here we go.
It's not actually as bad as I thought, but the turtle set in really quick. Okay.